especially if he, and then he's moving up in weight also?
No, he's already, I'm saying for Triple G he moved up.
Oh, okay.
But how about this? I talked to Ali Abdelaziz, Pita.
Who's that?
The manager of Khabib, the manager of a lot of UFC superstars.
Okay, yeah.
That he's working on Ryan Garcia against Henry Cejudo.
On a boxing fight.
Yes, boxing.
And it's all Ryan Garcia, you know. Cejudo's a tough motherfucker, you know. He's tough. He fucking, you know, he's a...
He's 10-0 in amateur boxing.
Did he fight amateur?
That's what his manager told
amateur.
Me. 10-0. But still, that's impressive.
Yeah, but no, the first 10 amateur fights
can't be competitive against Ryan Garcia in a professional fight. Not in a professional fight. Not.
Okay. Joseph Adorno's 135. How about him and Ryan?
Oh, in the future, why not? Those are all possible fights.
Where did Tanahara go? There's talks of him and Ryan, too.
Yeah, there's been talks, but, you know, we haven't really said him. There's already been talks, like, what, 2 dates already, and we haven't been able to get it. So, you know, I could say those are just talks. Because we have already before, like a couple times already, and we even agree on the verses and everything, but then at the end it doesn't happen, so, you know.
So he came that close to fighting Ryan already, with purse and everything?
No, not that close, because it was never official, but our side was already, he had already signed a contract and everything. Well, no, my bad, not signed the contract. No, we had already agreed on the purse and everything, the date and everything, but it just doesn't happen.
But Hector, when it happens, you're ready.
Yeah, I've been ready.
Who's the A side in that fight? Who's the favorite, do you think?
Yeah, well, Ryan, you know, we gotta be realistic too, you know, that's fine, we don't mind.
Do you prefer being the underdog in fights, Robert, your fighters?
No, it doesn't matter, you know.
Same thing.
We don't. It feels much better when you're the underdog and you win, you pull it off and prove a lot of people wrong. It feels much better. But it's not like, oh, I prefer that or I don't. It doesn't make a difference.
What is Franco? Is the favorite or the underdog?
I think he's the underdog.
Franco, are you the favorite in your fight?
No, I'm the underdog.
So when you pull it off, it's a bigger upset. It's a shock in the world.
Yeah.
Say, I'm not surprised, motherfuckers.
Yeah.
I think that the Vegas odds are 7-1, Robert.
I know, it's fucking,
that's crazy.
Not
Louis was 16-1, and look at that.
Yep. But that's all right. That's good.
In the end of the day, it's what you do in the ring, not what the experts think or say or... Pita, you know that all the guys here were watching the Food Network today?
I'm sure, cutting weight.
Why? Why would you watch the Food Network? And then they send pictures on the DM of food.
That's stupid.
I don't know why they would do that.
That's the last thing I would want to be looking at.
Josh, I was happy.
That's the last thing I would want to be looking at.
The one person I want to ask about weight cut is Michelle's cousin, Pantera.
Yeah, big.
Robert, he goes down from 180 to 145, and he says it's easy.
Those MMA guys
no,
know.
It's not easy. You cannot say
it's not easy.
But how does he do a 40 pounds?
Yeah, I was going to bring that
to
you.
And he's a tall dude, too.
We're going to leave to Big Jesus on the way back when I pick up these guys to go to the 530 guy with the bags and stuff.
I think we've got